Dobrodošli, poštovani gosti. Dobrodošli na 12. ediciju Međunarodnog muzičkog festivala Harmonika Fest. U toku dva dana imat ćete prilike da uživate u bogatom sadržaju koji smo za vas pripremili. U cjelodnevno druženje, održavanje takmičarskih disciplina, svi zainteresovani imat će priliku da prisustvuju koncertima, predavanju, a za učenike i studente organizovali smo i majstorsku radionicu koju će održati predsjednik Svjetske konfederacije akordeonista gospodin Mirko Patarin. Za večeras smo predvidili koncert Radomira Toa, umjetnika koji je osvojio sva najznačajnija takmičenja za harmoniku. Sada bih pozvala gospodina Predraga Jankovića, direktora festivala, da vam se obrati.
Konfederacija akordeonista gospodine Mirko Patarini, poštovani članovi žirija, dragi umjetnici, drage kolege, učenici i studenti, predstavnici medija. Čast mi je i veliko zadovoljstvo što vas mogu pozdraviti u ime organizacionog tima i svoje lično ime kao osnivača i direktora Međunarodnog muzičkog festivala Harmonika Fest. Prvo što želim da istaknem je da se festival u kontinuitetu realizuje u saradnji sa Centrom za kulturu Tivat, Opštinom Tivat, Univerzitetom Crne Gore, Muzičkom akademijom i Ministarstvom kulture i medija. Kontinuiranim razvojem festivala, prepoznatljivim umjetničkim i edukativnim kvalitetima, kao i učešćem sve većeg broja učesnika i takmičara iz godine u godinu, festival je postao prepoznatljiv i na mapi najznačajnijih evropskih festivala za klasičnu harmoniku, na što smo posebno ponosni. Proteklih 11 godina smo se trudili da kvalitet bude imperativ, odnosno osnova našeg festivala. Kada kažem kvalitet, imam u vidu ne samo dobru organizaciju, već ono što je najvažnije, stručnost i kompetencije koje krase renomirane članove međunarodnog žirija. Također, veliki doprinos festivalu dali su i svjetski priznati umjetnici koji su svojim nastupima osnažili i obogatili ovaj projekat. Sarađivali smo uvijek sa najboljima. 2010. godine, kada je i osnovan festival, koncert je održao najpoznatiji svjetski violončelista današnjice, Stjepan Hauser. Na festivalu su nastupili Juri Šiškin, Sergio Sokin, Renzo Ruđeri, Pavel Fenjuk, Vladimir Mić, Petar Marić, Nikola Peković, Roman Žbanov, Dominik Jomorin i mnogi drugi umjetnici. Još jednom ću ponoviti, sarađivali smo sa najboljima, a jedan od najboljih i najcjenjenijih svjetskih profesora je i Radomir Tomić, utemeljivač moderne škole harmonike na našim prostorima. Dugujemo mu veliku zahvalnost na podršci tokom svih godina postojanja festivala i ovom prilikom želim da mu uručim plaketu za doprinos razvoju festivala. Pozivam profesora Radomira Tomića da primi ovu plaketu. Gospodin Mirko Patarin, zamolio bih vas da ga sačekam ovdje na sceni i da nam se obrati. Izvolite.
Thank you, good evening. You can hear me?
Yes.
It's more space. but I use it to speak in a small opera theater in Spoleto. So I'm very happy to see that live events started again also in Montenegro, and that many students and many teachers are here. Is it necessary to translate, or?
We ask Milena to translate.
Okay. Veoma mi je drago što je deo Harmonika Festa i što posle nekoliko godina odsustva Harmonika Festa sa online takmičenjima smo prešli na uživo i što vidi veliki broj učenika i takmičara.
And I want simply to thank you, the teachers, the young students and their families that support these events.
Želim prvenstveno da se zahvalim takmičarima, žiriju kao i roditeljima koji podržavaju ovaj festival, ovaj događaj.
Because even if we are living a very, very difficult times today,
iako živimo u teškim danas vremenima,
I think that if you want to have a better society, we have to work to make better people, better single persons.
Ukoliko želimo da imamo dobro društvo, trebali bi prvo da radimo na pojedincima da oni budu bolji.
And music and art education, in my opinion, is the best way.
A muzika i umjetnička umjetnost to omogućavaju. Je najbolji način za to.
Thank you very much.
Hvala vam.
Predsjednika opštine Tivat, gospodina Željka Komnenovića, kojeg ovog prilikom pozivam da dođe na scenu i otvori 12. Međunarodni muzički festival Harmonika Fest.
Uvaženi gospodine Jankoviću, uvažena gospodo, poštovani profesori, dragi studenti, prvo želim da vam poželim dobrodošlicu u Tivat, izrazim zadovoljstvo što ste opet u našem gradu nakon 2 godine pauze zbog pandemije koronavirusa. Dakle, muzika zaista otvara vidike, širi granice, muzičari su uvijek najbolji ambasadori sredina iz kojih potiču, a Tivat je grad koji baštini viševjekovnu tradiciju u muziciranju i prije svega gajanju muzičke kulture. Zato je zaista pravo zadovoljstvo što su u našem gradu uvijek u doba godinu od oba ljeta, tačnije najznamenitiji muzičari, ali i muzički pedagozi i što naša djeca imaju od koga i šta da nauče, šta da vide i šta da čuju. To je jedna velika vrijednost i meni je zaista drago što upravo gospodin Janković svoj entuzijazam i entuzijazam svojih kolega, svojih saradnika iskazuje upravo u Tivtu, a što Tiva će uvijek biti tu da pomogne koliko može i da podrži ovakve manifestacije koje imaju ne samo muzičku, nego i pedagošku i akademsku, a i naučnu komponentu. Hvala vam svima, želim vam ugodan boravak u našem gradu. Uživajte i proglašavam 12. Harmonika Fest otvorenim. Hvala vam.
Thanks a lot for coming here. I'm it's not actually a time in like in my home country for a concert, but I'm used to, of course, to play at this hour. As I said, it's a pleasure for me to be here. I want to say a big thank you to Predrag for inviting me here. And I'll just try a bit to introduce some of the pieces which I'll play today. I hope everybody will understand it. So, first piece is by Johann Sebastian Bach. It's Passacaglia Fugue in C minor. This is one, in my opinion, one of the most monumental works by Bach. For me, this piece actually has a quite big history. I remember myself, like in music school, on the last year of music school, I was coming at my teacher and asking, "Hey, I really want to play this piece." She was looking at me and like saying, "It's too hard, you will not manage." I say, "No, but I really want." I say, "Okay, try." So I tried for a few weeks and I understood that the teacher was right. After that, yeah, of course I took it back. And it's a part of one of my projects, like organ music by Bach especially, arranged for accordion. This is my CD with it, so it's included there. As I said, it's a piece which is like, you can see all the life and all the, let's say somehow, tragedy of life, all the, in this first theme. It's like how the life starts and how it ends, like, let's say, on the same point. So I hope you'll enjoy and thank you for coming again.
Thank you.
piece, as you now can see in your program, it's Liszt. It's actually, I can say maybe it's my favorite composer after Bach. It's why I decided, of course, to compose it today. This piece actually has also quite a long history with me, but it's long and it's short and intense, but I feel it as long as, like, for example, Sakai. I will play today just from 7th movement to 12th, from Transcendental Etudes. It's actually written for piano, this piece, and it's Liszt actually wrote firstly one version, just Etudes for piano, let's say, and after he made it more difficult, a second version, like Grand Etudes for piano, and he ended up with Transcendental Etudes, which is actually just like harder than the first two versions. It's published by Edition Henle in Germany, and this edition has a, it's quite fine actually for me. This edition has a rank, like it puts each piece or each movement on how hard it is, just on levels. And even says on the website, I found like this sheet, it's like has the most difficult piece, like 9 from 9 from all published by this edition. So I will not speak much more. I hope you will enjoy this part. It's just like as I said, it's not really in Moldova a dinner time or a concert time, but as I see here it is. Even so, it's somehow, let's say, a bigger meal for you, like these 6 parts. Thanks, I hope you will enjoy. I prepared as a last piece something really different from what you heard before. It's a suite of Moldovan folk songs. As I'm coming from Moldova, I should show you some of our tradition. It's actually a suite which is composed by, let's say, three parts, but actually by only two. It's named Hor, which maybe some of you know what it means, and it's Hororab. I mean, Hor is the same name. I don't understand this, like, we couldn't find another new name for the second piece, but we just named like Horasto, which is actually totally different genre of first piece. So you'll hear just, like, let's say, Dessert, which is a suite of modern songs. It's really great to be here and such a great audience. But I'll show you one piece. It's actually written for me. It's named Dixie Merucica, but it's like on, let's say, on style of Dixieland. But actually, I can name it as a joke, just piece joke. Thanks a lot, and thanks, Predrag, this one is for you. Thanks. Thanks again, and of course, if you want a memory, you can take one of the CDs. Thanks a lot, and see you at the next concert.
Imali smo prilike da čujemo, po meni možda i najboljeg mladog harmonikaša
svjetska takmičenja za harmoniku, što o čemu najbolje govori njegova biografija, mogu slobodno da kažem da se ubraja u red najboljih svjetskih umjetnika kada je klasična harmonika u pitanju. Hvala vam još jednom i pozivam vas da dođete sutra da čujete mladu crnogorsku scenu harmonikaša, to su najbolji naši mladi harmonikaši iz nižih muzičkih škola, srednjih muzičkih škola i sa muzičke akademije, nakon čega ćemo čuti i koncert pobjednika ovogodišnjeg festivala. Pozivam vas da dođete ovako u velikom broju i sutra također. Hvala.